Hi there, my name's Roland Boothby. Welcome to the Global Poker League and this special look at how the GPL finals were won and lost. It's the opening match of the GPL finals. Montreal Nationals and San Francisco Rush battle it out neck and neck all the way to a final game seven, tied at three wins apiece. The match comes down to Timex and Jonathan Jaffe playing heads up for all the marbles and a spot in the GPL Americas Conference Final. Jaffe and Timex spend time jostling for position till an out-of-the-box encounter in hand five with Timex's 6-7 suited versus Jaffe's 5-3 suited that left Jaffe crippled and unable to recover. We pick up the action on the turn. Timex has flopped the nuts and even turned a flush draw. Jaffe has a measly pair of fives.
Man, how much do you love your life when you're in this spot?
Did you flop the nuts?
Oh!
You have to tell the other person if you did.
$58,000 chips in the middle.
Too much.
I mean, I feel like you could just never call this. When you ask the guy, did you flop the nuts? And then you call here with one pair, and you see he did flop the nuts. You're just like, ah, I'm dumb.
The flush draw is busted, but this bluff catch is so bad. It's still so bad.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Yes.
Closer.
Exactly.
Two of them.
Blinked. He blinked for the first time in 2 minutes.
I just don't think you let up on your bottom of your range. Even though you did versus Raz at one.
Mike McDonald is pretty balanced in general.
You know, players, they're not bluffing that often.
Yeah.
That you can do in like in cash games. Sure.
You still have King Six suited, right?
Giant misstep by Jaffe, hero calling half his stack off with fourth pair against the flop straight of Timex. Jaffe never recovers and eventually blinds down and loses the match. In no small part to playing a bit more passively after this misread. It's the second match in the Americas playoffs. The Sao Paulo Metropolitans find themselves in a commanding position in their tussle with LA Sunset after victories for Darren Elias and Thiago Nishihima given them a 2-1 lead. In his second match in the cube, Elias has the opportunity to put the Metropolitans on the verge of the conference final with a victory over Olivier Bousquet. In hand 17, a huge pot ensues, which have a profound effect on the course of the match. We join the action on the turn. Olivier is in a commanding position on a king 9 5 ace board with ace jack. Elias holding 9-4 for a pair of nines.
Boom.
Is that a bracelet event? JBCD on Twitch says the GPL is cool. I like the format. I am rooting for the Montreals, of course.
Of course. Elias coming into this finals, Joe, hot. 48th at WPT Montreal. That was won by Mike Sexton.
Rickadoo, rickadoo.
Yeah, followed that up by a ninth place finish in the main event in the Intercoupe, the New Jersey Championship of Online Poker.
Elias's second pair just went to third pair on this turn. And this pot is pretty, pretty big. Almost 100K in the middle. Darren just called a sizable bet on the turn. Not a whole lot of nines beating right now. I was actually pretty surprised to see Elias call the turn, and he may feel compelled if he called turn to call river. This river bet isn't much more. than the turn bet was. Turn bet was 26,000. This is 36,000.
He lets it go.
Makes the right fold.
With Elias down to crumbs, Busquet was able to finish the job in hand 33 and pull the sunset level in this crucial match. Later, he would defeat Thiago Nishihima in the decider to send the sunset through to the America's Conference Final. It's the opening game in the Eurasian playoffs, and Anatoly's long-standing wish of taking on London Royals has come to fruition. Anatoly promises the fans a sweep, and they are well underway, starting off the match with two straight wins, till a resurgent Igor Kurganov brings the streak to a halt, beating Andrei Patschuk in Game 3 to bring London back into contention. Kurganov goes back into the cube in the very next game, taking on Yaroshevsky in an Igor versus Igor battle, with the opportunity to tie things up at two apiece. But after deciding to play a big pot with 8-7 suited versus Yaroshevsky's nines, he puts himself into a chip deficit he can't crawl out from. We pick up the hand pre-flop, where Yaroshevsky is open from the button with his nines.
And looks like we got a four bet incoming. Four bet alert. Wauga. Sweet looking board for nines. No longer has three outs. He's got more. That's right. You people at home. No one back there can help you.
How many chips do you have?
43,000. 55,000. 33,000. 69,000.
Igor's just been put all in by Igor.
London goes down 3-1 and on the brink of elimination. Patschuk puts the final nail in the coffin in Game 5 as he sends Justin Bonomo along with the London Royals packing back to Big Ben and Moscow off to the GPL Eurasia Conference Finals. It's the second match in the Eurasian Conference Final and Berlin Bears have nudged ahead of Hong Kong Stars 3-2 going into Game 6. Berlin are on the verge of qualification. Bill Perkins established a healthy lead over Hong Kong manager Selina Lin. In hand 39, the deck presents him with a golden opportunity to get Berlin over the line.
Sixes versus queens. Selina starts the hand with 25 big blinds. She raises. Bill figuring out his three bet amount. Made it real enticing for her. There goes the slider bar. Selina Lin all in. Oh no, is he gonna slow roll her? What is happening? There's the call. Selina Lin is behind and at risk. No, wow, what a mean cackle that was.
Ladies, no sixes.
Oh, yes, six on the turn. Yes, justice.
Oh no.
What the? Spoke too soon. Are you kidding me? I was robbed!
Justice.
Oh.
Sickening turn for Bill Perkins and the match continues. In the very next hand, the players once again find hand they're willing to invest their entire stacks with. This time it's Selina, a huge favorite to take down game 6 and send the match to a decider.
That is just... so ridiculous.
And now he's dominated.
Yeah, we are not done yet. Actually, we could be done here, Joe. Could be seeing a game 7 if Selina
not fair.
Wins this one.
I'd like to register a formal complaint.
The complaint's been reviewed and denied.
Request denied.
Yep. Oh.
Oh, Bill gets it all in. Dominated. Does a flop a draw.
Come on.
Nine yes. on the turn. That's going to yes. make things a lot justice. Easier on him. King.
Justice king. Is served.
There's still one card to come, oh. but it is not a king. So,
yes.
So
this time it's Selena who's dealt the deathly turn. Bill is back in prime position to lead Berlin into a conference final against Moscow Wolverines. With shallow stacks, it's only a mere nine hands until the players find themselves all in for a third time.
Oh, well, Selena has shoved on Bill, and he's got an ace. I think for 12 big blinds, this is supposed to be a call.
59,000 you stuck in there.
And call he does. This could be.
Oh my God.
Wow, king on the flop.
Is there a God?
Yeah, it's called poker God.
Yes,
there is a God.
It's a God that responds to whining,
God
I guess.
Shined on me today. Thank
Full
the Lord.
House
Thank
for Bill Lord. Perkins, who manages to win the fourth game.
Fascinating and entertaining match. She's Berlin victorious. Billionaire baller Perkins, who brought his own unique style to the cube, would live to give fans the chance to experience his unconventional style once more as Berlin marched on. The GPL heads into the America's Conference Final, with Montreal Nationals taking on LA Sunset after wins over San Francisco Rush and Sao Paulo Metropolitans respectively in the previous round. Game 6 sees a battle of team managers. Maria Ho has been successfully putting pressure on Marc-Andre Ladisaur throughout what's turned into a marathon match. In a key turning point in the match, Maria elects to get stickier than an old lollipop with King Deuce versus Mark's value bet barreling of Ace-10 suited on what turns out to be an Ace-King board. A river call by Maria relinquishes the chip lead in a must-win game for LA. After a raise pre by Marc-Andre and a call, we join the action on the flop.
LA Sunset, 2 minute warning.
He's in big trouble here. Mark's hand underrepped. Tyler says he dresses it up as Otto every year.
Midwest Mike asking if we commentate every stream. Technically, no, but I mean, they just keep on throwing some matches on there, and we're here.
Oh, not now, Randy. We were just starting to get them on our side.
Randy.
Maria calls. Wowee, this was a big pot. Marc-Andre Ladisaur now in the lead.
The hand proves pivotal as Maria never recovers the lead and her team ends up bowing out in a 4-2 win for Montreal. If Maria scoops this pot, the two finalists are likely headed for a game 7, but shallow stacks left little room for maneuver. If Maria scoops the pot, the two finalists are likely headed for a game 7, but shallow stacks left little room for maneuver. Maria was left to wonder whether Ladisaur would have been bold enough to three barrel without a strong holding, knowing that his franchise are in a commanding spot on the verge of the GPL final. It's the Eurasian Conference Final. Things are locked at 3 each between Berlin Bears and Moscow Wolverines. GPL has been sugary and sweet so far, but things are about to get salty in the cube as the pressure of an deciding match gets the grip on Anatoly Filatov and Brian Rast, manager and de facto manager of their respective franchises. We pick up the action in hand 15, where a seemingly innocuous pot gets the not-so-thinly veiled jibes flowing by hand's end.
Mm. turn is pretty much going to clinch this for Filatov. Rast has got some outs. Only 9% of the time will he hit them. For Rast, at least. Oh. Hey, he's going to rep the flush, maybe.
So you're going to have the gut shot again?
Or gut shot he can rep.
Sorry, guys.
Or an ace.
If I'm wrong.
Anatoly calls. He is not wrong. That is going to put the chip lead back in his favor.
Oops, got shot.
The awkward exchange continues into the next hand, where Rast appears determined to clarify his thoughts on Anatoly's read in the previous hand.
I think I could just have an ace or better.
You could?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A gut shot. Like I
exactly
need a straight to bet that.
Uh-oh, here we go.
A little saltiness.
I mean, the guy hasn't had running water for days.
I mean, at least an ace or better what I thought I was representing, which I guess would have been a fine bet because you called with a jack. I mean, I probably would have called with your hand too, but I'm just saying, like, I hit a gut shot is a pretty random thing to think, especially when you have a queen.
I feel like I'm at the dinner table and mommy and daddy are fighting. You just don't want to escalate it. You don't want it to be your fault.
You're like, all right.
Don't knock over the juice, Eric. No! So Rast makes top pair. Flush draw for Filatov. And Filatov makes his flush on the river. Rast checks. Like he's considering paying off another. This time he gets away.
Good fold.
Although Anatoly gets the better of Rast in our featured hand, it would be Rast who would go on to seal the victory for Berlin 40 hands later after an epic tussle. Hello and welcome to the roundup of the GPL finals, where we go over the crucial hands that decided season one of the Global Poker League. Despite Berlin Bears engineering the perfect start through Sorrel Mitzi in Game 1, it was Montreal who had secured the upper hand by Game 4 after winning 3 on the spin. The significance of Game 5 could not be overlooked. If Montreal could clinch it, they would open up a 4-1 lead in this best of 11 encounter, whereas a Berlin triumph in Game 5 would see the match pulled back to 3-2. Jason Lavallee and Brian Rast entered the cube with the hopes of their franchises resting on their shoulders. Viewers were not left waiting for fireworks, and the fuse was ignited in Hand 4. We pick up the action pre-flop, where both players have picked up a pair.
You lost last night. Were you able to get some sleep? Were you able to recover?
Yeah. You're doing well. I slept pretty well.
Good. A lot of pressure on the team yesterday, so you needed to sleep that off, of course.
Yeah. We could have the huge pot now.
Yep.
I like this, the 3-bet, because like they're too deep, he has to 3-bet more. But if you hit your set, you give him a lot of chips.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Wow. Zero reaction from Rast.
Wow, Jason just check this board.
Yeah. Check.
That's a good card for Jason. Has more equity now.
Yeah, there's that flush draw.
Check, come on. To the river.
Looks like he will bet 47,000. Nicole.
If he bets like pot, Jason could fold it.
Oh, he's about all in. Way more pot. Wow.
Hey, Jason Lavallee, is the word polarized applicable now? He told me he was impressed that I used the word polarized twice yesterday, and only one of the times it wasn't applicable.
still too deep to make a hurricane here. I know what happened now. The guy told fold, and the other guy told, come on, call, right. You have to be a hero.
I don't know.
Jason.
Like, first instinct is to call. So I feel like my range is capped. And I think you probably think I overfold here.
I think Jason's just making this dramatic.
Turn barrels, if it makes sense. Like,
actually, when Brian calls a 3-bet, usually a lot of suited hands, so it's more flushes in his range.
I think once I check call, you just assume that I don't have it, unless you're leveling me. Which is a likely possibility.
Make fake folding.
Yeah.
It's such an interesting play.
Jason was actually practicing fake folding earlier.
And you blocked most of my bluff catching range. This doesn't really make sense.
And he calls.
No.
Jason calls.
Kind of a...
Wow.
I flopped a set, but...
Brian Rast.
An eye-popping overbet from Rast. The stubborn river call from Lavallee, and the game is over, almost before it begun. Berlin are back in the match, 3-2, but it's still Montreal with a slight advantage. Montreal, undeterred by defeat in Game 5, restored breathing space in Game 6 after Pascal Lefrancois tamed Sorrel Mitzi. With a 2-point cushion renewed, Montreal sent Timex in to attempt and dampen the spirits of the effervescent billionaire Bill Perkins and put Montreal within two of victory. The early goings are favorable to Perkins, and he manages to get Timex all in by hand 9.
Ace queen against ace 10. What do you think? 21 big blinds, a little too much to get it in here?
Yeah, this might be it.
You're right, Mike.
Let me think about this for a second. I've got a good one.
Oh dear. How good?
Pretty good. Do you have a pair?
No pair.
You got a pair, you're ahead, so you can relax.
Look who's here.
Well, how is it like a coin flip or a bent coin flip?
So a big pair, you do have a big pair over there? Oh shit.
I don't know. I don't know if I have a pair, but I don't know if I have a little pair or a small pair.
All right, I'll run it.
Oh, okay. Mike is dominated.
Do not get me.
Four. That was a mighty close.
Do not 10 ball me.
Oh, he did 10 ball you.
Oh my God!
There's
no justice for Perkins.
Tilt juice, I drank my tilt juice.
It's a perfect 10 for Timex, and the gasp from inside the cube are almost enough to break through the impenetrable glass. Would there be an exact reverse of the same situation with a perfect chance for karma to restore equilibrium inside the cube? Surely not.
Okay.
Wear a suit.
All right, bit of a setup developing.
Mike will shove here. Or maybe... No, they're not that deep. Maybe because he could 3-bet too, but probably for this kind of race.
All in and call. Domination.
Whoa.
Perkins hits his 10.
Diamond.
Could it be?
Justice or not?
If there's a diamond, I'm gonna cry. Oh, could it be? I actually, revenge?
Just not yet.
Oh. Yes.
All right, the double up.
Finally, I win one of these things.
Well, Bill gets it in bad and wins.
Oh my God.
Mike is left with 6 big blinds and eventually succumbs, and the Bears are back in it at 4-3. Jason Lavallee, after costing Montreal Game 5 with incorrect hero call against Rast, finds himself in another tricky spot in Game 8. Once again in a big pot with a bluff catcher, and once again up against Rast. We join the action on the flop.
Now it really matters to hit some boards or to pick up a good hands. And of course, to get lucky in all ends. Now Brian has an equity. Here, and this is a question: Would Ryan Brust pull
happens bluff to the best or ones. Not?
10 is a kind of blank.
That's most of the pot.
That's a tough spot for Jason now. Brian representing like...
Yeah, what is he repping?
Two pair, like 4-2.
Something pretty strong.
Something like 5-2s.
I don't even know.
I mean, I can see the cards and I barely know.
Having this hand, call with a bunch of other stuff.
Jason blocked thumb of two pairs, like five deuce.
Yeah.
The pain. Right. The suffering. He calls.
I don't know what that face means.
It means you win, brother.
Okay, I wasn't sure if it's like a...
Redemption for Lavallee, who'd gone to see out Game 8 and put Montreal 5-3 up and firmly in command. Montreal are a single game away from sealing the GPL Season 1, but alas, Berlin Bears come storming back with two consecutive wins to take the match in the GPL Season 1 to a decider. Comes down to Pascal Lefrancois versus Brian Rast. Heads up for $100,000 and the GPL Season 1 championship honours. We pick up the final action of GPL Season 1 in hand 43, where Rast has taken a flop with 10-8 off after Lefrancois has limped on the button with queens.
Limps in, flops top set. Brian Rast, second pair. He is firing into the abyss.
Hit the nuts. Oh, that.
This is awful. This is more than likely going to be ball game.
That's the worst cut possible for Berlin.
Xuan Lu on Twitch can't breathe.
Now you can.
Rast with 310k left behind. Bets at 75. Does it go in here or on the river?
They're laughing. They know what will happen next.
Beautiful smiles.
Montreal knows this is over.
Jack of spades. Not spades. Spades? Check fold.
That would be pretty amazing.
The new champion. We have the first champion now.
Brian puts it all in.
That'll do it.
Pascal calls. It is over. GPL Season 1. The champions are the Montreal Nationals.
A dream flop for Lefrancois, an ugly turn for Rast, and the GPL has crowned its inaugural champions, the Montreal Nationals. After dominating their conference from the outset, the Nationals have claimed the title that no one can say they didn't fully deserve. Berlin Bears, under the guidance of manager Philip Grusin, put in a fine underdog performance in the finals and will be looking to go one better when they return for Season 2.